NASA have plunged three spacecraft into the gas giant planet. Two of them are Galileo and Cassini, where at the end of their missions when they met their doom in the atmosphere of Jupiter and Saturn respectively. But the Galileo spacecraft arrived with a passenger, a probe that designed to drop into a gas giant's atmosphere. But could we one day send a spacecraft deeper into a gas chain such as Jupiter or Saturn or other exobodies? Given that these enormous planets may not have a solid surface on which to crash, could a spacecraft fly through a gas chain? The answer is no, maybe. A spacecraft could not survive a trip through a gas giant planet. The problem with trying to fly through a gas giant is that the density, pressure, and temperature all increases to such enormous level as you penetrate down into the interior. Near the center of the Jupiter, normally the gaseous hydrogen becomes a liquid metal, making this region as exotic as the surface of the sun. First, the ideal gas giant probe would have to be shaped like a bullet to improve the aerodynamics and allow it to plummet as far down as possible. As the spacecraft started its descent, it would encounter a wispy ammonia clouds and potentially pass through blue skies due to the same phenomenon of light scattering that occurs in the Earth's atmosphere. After passing through the gunky, bready brown clouds of ammonium hydrosulfide, the spacecraft would reach about 50 miles or 80 kilometers deep and possibly light up by massive lightning storms. Much deeper than that, between 4,350 to 8,700 miles, the spacecraft would encounter an atmosphere so hot that the atmosphere itself would glow. This is where the temperature rises to tens and thousands of degrees Celsius and pressure rises to megabars, and this is where the spacecraft starts to disintegrate. In the still mysterious regions of Jupiter's interior, the hydrogen and helium became a fluid. From the Juno mission, which launched in 2011, the scientists have figured out that the Jupiter doesn't have a solid core, but rather a diffuse core of materials including nitrogen, carbon, and even iron. By the time the spacecraft get to this fuzzy mixed core, the spacecraft will be no more. So as of now, there is very little human technology that can penetrate gaseous planets. Who knows, soon in 100 years anything can change, like what happened in last 100 years. So what do you think? Can human build a spacecraft that can enter any gaseous planet and survive?